Rich a lot later than I expected. Now I'm too old to enjoy my money.
John Entwistle talking back in 1978. Deep in the heart of the English countryside, John is now enjoying life as Stow-on-the-Wold's resident rock star. His 14-bedroom mansion comes complete with built-in recording studio and, of course, the obligatory swimming pool. Included among the 9 cars he owns is a Rolls-Royce, now converted to an estate to take his Irish wolfhound, Fitz. Waiting for the ex-Who drummer, Kenny Jones, to arrive, John looks back to the last days of the Who.
I've kind of got mixed feelings about the demise of the Who. When I first heard that it was going to break up, I was kind of outraged and relieved at the same time. I don't know, maybe it was a good thing for the individual members. I don't think it was a very good thing for the public, because I don't think there's anything to replace the Who around, certainly not live concert-wise. My main regrets are that we didn't actually sort of work any harder, we did. I mean, we just didn't seem, it seemed to be a part-time band, semi-professional, you know. I could have actually taken a day job and still staying in the band and all. Live Aid actually put the final nail in the coffin. I think it made us realise that you just couldn't exist in with the same lineup ever again. Yeah.
Because I think The Who have kind of made their mark and done their bit, and I think that The Who, the members of The Who, probably are, although probably everybody misses The Who, probably are still frustrated a bit, and they want to do. They've devoted most of their life to The Who, and it'd be nice if everybody devoted some time to themselves in the, for their own projects, not necessarily for fortune, but for personal satisfaction.
Yeah, some city zookeeper let a couple of families of grey squirrels go in like 1800s or something.
Really?
Now there's millions of them.
God, so that's what we're after, is it?
Kenny played drums with The Who for 3 years, until they split in 1982. Since then, he's been working on a variety of solo projects. Bass guitarist John has just formed a brand new rock group, as yet unnamed, and they're about to record their debut album.
So we're going to go and blow their brains out then?
Joking, you never see any.
God. This'll be fun.
It's taken me 3 years, or ever since The Who's last concert, to actually form the band that I have now. Andy Barnett on guitar, Andy Nye on keyboards, and Zach Starkey on drums. And Zach kind of came and went and came back again. He felt that we had to find a singer to take over the lead, or most of the lead vocal work from us. And we're still looking for them. I mean, let's hope by the time this thing goes out, I've found one.
You haven't got a name for it, have you?
Yeah. I wish you were thinking of names, and then we figure out, the press are going to have a field day with that one.
Yeah.
For a while, we're going to call it The End.
You don't know what songs we're doing yet, do you?
John and Kenny are getting worried about the reunion of The Who, taking place at the Band Aid concert. It's a live gig which poses serious problems for them both.
Yeah, so we'll have an argument about what numbers and do it anyway.
Right.
I mean, one of them's got to be well before we can.
Yeah, because we've only got 20 minutes set, haven't we, so...
Yeah.
Got to be the cream of the crop, isn't it?
Yeah, songs that epitomise the Who, I suppose.
I think, so the last time we played together was over 3 years, wasn't it?
Yeah, we better do some simple ones because I can't
try to remember them.
You know. I know I sat down and tried to play Won't Get Forward Again from memory the other day.
Yeah. Well, luckily I've got some old tapes at home, synthesizer tapes. You know.
Oh, you got that?
That's how you did it.
Yeah.
Shaking a baby now.
thing I ever get nervous about. I have these dreams before. You know, if we haven't been touring for a while, I'm supposed to do a tour. I have these dreams about equipment going wrong and rubbing bases and stuff like that. I never get nervous about my own ability. I get nervous of the equipment acting up. You know. And the rubberneck bass syndrome always comes back before I start touring. So I'll probably get that the night before, wake up in a sweat, go and check that my bass hasn't got a rubber neck, and I'll be fine.
Don't have any problems with the rhino, do you, around here?
No.
Stampeding?
I've got some repellent. Keeps them away. Yeah.
Good. Into the jungle. That poo, yeah?
That what?
Big dollop. With all the flies on.
Probably one of these. That's a Japanese Yokohama.
Squinty eyes, eh?
That's copper doing very Japanese.
What are you doing solo-wise? I mean, not the band, the new band, but
I was going to try and do it at the same time. I've got some stuff that's not really suitable for the band. I was going to...
Oh, great. So you're going to be busy then?
Well, now I've got the studio, I might as well use it.
Yeah. Yeah.
What are you up to?
I'm actually attempting a solo project, but because, you know, if I don't write songs, I've got to wait for songs to come in.
Uh-huh.
I've done one song, which is a demo with synthesizers and stuff.
I can't say synthesizer. Better not play one, then.
Better not play one, yeah. But I was thinking if you get time, maybe you put a bass on it.
Yeah,
yeah, really good.
Oh, my God, there's a mad dog coming at the picture.
Yeah, are we supposed to shoot things like that? Big things.
No,
like
that's not a squirrel.
It's a grey. It's grey.
It's grey with a bushy tail.
Yeah. My God, the squirrels are big round here.
Yeah, well, we'll have a go at it.
Yeah.
Is it simple? Easy.
It's a simple little commercial ditty.
Oh, jolly good.
That my cousin Derek wrote. But that's the only one I've got at the moment.
Really?
I'm waiting for songs to come in. Morris Gibbs apparently got two.
Only two?
Yeah, only two. Well, he's only got two, he'd give them me. So as and when they come in, I'll record them.
Yeah.
But I'm in no rush, so it's fine. I've been having my own studio, so great.
All right, yeah, that's pretty useful.
Right,
well, if you need a bass player, I'm out of work at the moment.
John and I have been friends for, God, over 20 years, and we've had a few experiences in our times together. He's more than a bass player. He's just, the way he plays is so different to any other bass player. He's more of a lead sort of bass player, if you like, lead guitarist sort of thing. I always sort of say that when I'm sitting in between